Hey, this is YBR back with Street Legal Racing Redline, and today we're gonna paint this car because a lot of you guys didn't like my super awesome multicolor paint job. I have no idea why. I think it's amazing, but a lot of you guys want that really boring and bland single color paint job. I have no idea why. It just removes the character from the car, but that's what we're gonna do. For the color, I'm gonna do random color five times, and whatever color we land on is the color we'll use. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's not bad. It's kind of like a red, and we're gonna need a few cans. So let's start with 3 cans of paint, and then we need to paint the body panel. So we'll start with the front bumper, hood, fender. Oh, that's not a fender. That's like the body of the car. Okay, and then side skirt, door. Okay, we're out of paint on that one, so we'll go to the next can. Door, roof, bumper, trunk, wing, door. Out of paint again. Door. And then side skirt. All right, so it's all one color, except for the mirror. Now it's all one color, and I have an idea that might actually look okay. What if we went and got a can of black paint and did that to the roof? Nah, it doesn't work. Some cars, they could pull that kind of look off, but the red right there, look at the camera dancing. I'm not touching nothing. The camera's like, I like this color though, YBR. Don't change it. Too bad, camera. I don't care what you like. But it didn't work because there was the red behind it. If it was all black, it might have worked. Well, what if I did something where it was like, okay, we're going to blow through paint really fast here. Let's see what this looks like. Oh, come on. I clicked on the wrong thing. And oh, now I don't have enough paint. All right, buy some more paint then. And I don't even know what color red I had initially. I'd have to like figure that out. So I was trying to do something like that. No, see, it paints too much of the sides. I was thinking maybe it would just paint kind of the roofish. No, it did not. Fix that. Do I have enough for that? Yes. There needs to be a way to merge the cans up so you could just kind of finish things up. And then if we wanted to, we could give it a little bit of a, I don't know, just like it's a little dirty. That looks awful. Wait, actually, hold on. That might actually work. It almost gives it like a, kind of like the sun is doing weird things look to it. Although it's really hard to get an angle for that. I like it. It looks really dumb, but at least it's a custom paint job. There's my custom paint job. It makes it more aggressive looking. A little more right there. Oh, goodness, that's too much and there's no undo. All right, that is the perfect spray can paint job. We need more on the back. Yes. This is so bad looking. I'm going to keep doing it. A little bit more there. Okay. We need more here because there's just that splop of black. There we go. Oh, yeah. Racing paint job. Just going to keep putting more black on it until I like it. Eventually, it has to not look terrible. When it all becomes black, it'll actually look good, right? Actually, you know what? There. That is good enough for me. There's no big splotches. Well, there are a few splotches, but there's less. You know, the annoying thing is this camera does not zoom out enough. I keep whacking my head into all the sides and stuff trying to look at this thing. All right, there we go. Paint job complete. And at the moment, I have no decals, but if I wanted to, I could go and buy some. See, now I can actually see what it looks like. It looks all right. Okay, no, it looks awful. It looks so bad. I don't, oh, well. No going back on it. That's my new car look. All right, let's get some decals on this thing. What do we got for decals to make it look like a race car? We got a lot of choices, actually. All right, what do I want? Animals or miscellaneous? What's miscellaneous? Nothing there. I want an animal on mine. I want an animal. Yeah, that's totally, uh-huh. I'm sure they have the rights to that. Yeah, I'm sure that's the way for all the logos. Oh, let's put some eyeballs on it. Okay, it said it has 5 decals in it or something, so that's all we need for that. And what else can we buy? We got logos. 7-Up. Yep, I'm sure they have the rights to that one. And when I say that, I mean, I bet they don't. The Bank of China. My secret Chinese car. We're just going to slap some stickers on this thing, and it's going to be good to go. I have no idea how to slap stickers on it. Oh, my goodness, that thing is huge. Smaller. Smaller. Is that even making it smaller? Yes. Got to click it like 100 times for it to be the right size. There, a little bit bigger. Yeah! This looks so dumb! Oh, that's awesome. Like, that's awful, but awesome how awful it is. Alright, Bank of China is actually gonna be mirrored, it looks like. We'll just put it on the roof. Nobody should know that the Bank of China is sponsoring this. Put it there, too. Doesn't really work with the black, so we gotta keep it on, like, the red area. I'm not even going to bother to, like, make it fit on there. It's just going to be, like, half sticking off. It's on the trunk and the spoiler, so from the right angle, it'll look right. We need more decals. Let's see what else can we put on this thing. Let's go with some more logos. We'll just grab a bunch. We'll grab some 7-Up logos. What else looks good? How about an Invictus logo? That has a pretty cool look to it. Yeah! KFC! Nah, let's not get the Marlboro one. I don't even smoke. What's the point of that? Rally Art, yes. We need those in Red Bull. Okay, we got some stickers now. We're good to go. We're gonna sticker this thing up. So 7-Up, oh my goodness, this is massive. 7-Up is here! And on the other side, yeah, well, the Colonel's here too! And on the back, we could get like a little Invictus horse unicorn thing. Don't forget Red Bull, it gives you wings! There you go, that is so ugly. It's beautiful, but it's hideous at the same time. So yeah, you thought you were gonna have a single colored car. No, I made it 10 times worse than before. This is what happens. We got a spot right there with no sticker. Hold on, we're going back into the paint shop. We gotta have my rally art. Like right in the quarter panel right there. Make it smaller though, so it could actually fit kind of realistically. Oh, that's perfect. Is there a space over here too? Yeah, what the heck. Double rally art. Oh, what? There's a rally art up in the front too? Okay, whatever. That's perfect then. Absolutely perfect. Let's go race this thing. Ooh, well first, let's swap out the tires. I want to put drags on the front and back. Because I think I like drags on front and back better. Now let's see what race we can do here. I don't want to do the same one we've been doing this whole time. We could do the Gateway Road Endurance Race, which is 20 laps long. Well, this is going to take a while. I won't make you watch all 20 laps, of course, because that'd be ridiculous. But we'll see what happens. Oh, look at your guys' cars. They're all so lame. Mine's the coolest by far. Like, my car, 100 times cooler. Is it faster? Probably, too. Taking off the launch, and yep. Oh, they crashed. They crashed. All right, how fast can I corner with this thing? Oh, yep. I was driving rudely by being rear-ended. How dare I be rear-ended? Stupid game. It's not my fault. I have no idea when to brake. I need to just start braking now. Okay, so I could have braked a little bit later. That was scared. Oh, I'm gonna get hit again. I hear them. I'm scared. Yep, I got hit. I couldn't steer in any harder. It's not my fault. It was literally them pulling up right where I had to go. Like, there's no way I could have avoided them. All right, we're gonna go fast and then stop right when we cross the line. All right, that seems to work. And apparently, we gotta avoid a car that's been flipped over in the middle of the road. By the way, if I hit them, yeah, I'm driving rudely, I bet. I'm sure the game would be like, hey, YBR, you hit that guy. That's so rude. Even though he flipped in the middle of the track and it's entirely his fault. Yeah, blame me. Okay, apparently everybody is busy crashing onto that guy, though. This really is an endurance race. None of the AI is going to be left eventually. And then I'm going to get disqualified out, so nobody's going to win. There's like a 4-car pileup or a 3-car pileup in that corner I have to somehow avoid. All right, we're going to brake extra much right here just so I can make sure I don't hit them. Oh, I got to really be on the inside right here. AI, I don't think they're going to be in that far in the inside based on what I've seen before. So they're going to continue crashing into that pile of cars over and over and over. What a bunch of geniuses they are. Looking at the map. Yep, they're crashing into them. I really wonder if there's going to be any cars left after 5 laps. Just mine with its awesome paint job. It's going to be the only car left. Oh, apparently, what? Some of them got flipped over and they're driving again. That is ridiculous. You would think they'd be pretty damaged considering they crashed at like 100 kilometers per hour or probably 80 miles per hour. Probably over 100 kilometers per hour. Either way though, I am killing it right here because I'm the only one who hasn't crashed apparently. So let's see what happens here for their car. Do they crash into the other one again? No. Yes, they crashed again. They are just gonna keep crashing into that car forever. That is their new goal in life, is to crash into the other car. Oh, there's another car that crashed somehow. Right in the middle of the road. I gotta go through this corner slower, though, because I never know where that car's gonna be. Like, now it's on the inside, so I gotta go on the outside. Four is the opposite. I'm coming up on a guy. I see him right ahead of me. Don't know how long it's gonna take me to catch him, but I'm gonna try to catch him. I'm actually not even going nearly as fast as I could with this thing. I think if I like slid through the corners and just powered through it, I could go a lot faster. But then I have the risk of crashing into things a lot easier, and I don't want to have that. So I guess the AI is just never going to hit that guy anymore, so he's totally out the race. And same goes for the other car by the start-finish line. So it's really just me and four other cars at this point. And this dude, whoa, what are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? What are you doing? If I hit you, I'm going to basically get, like, super penalized. So can you not just swerve all over the road like an absolute maniac? This is scary. Like, I don't want to get the penalty. Wow, this dude trying to take me out of the road. Just go. Get by that guy. Oh, now I'm going way too fast in the corner. Oh, no. Thanks. What a awful, awful driver. And, like, he's awful because of the disrespect he did. Making me crash just to pass him. Wow. All right, so I'm coming up on some cars again, and okay. That guy just decided to ride the wall a little bit. I don't know if it was the car in front of him kind of messed him up or what, but that was interesting. I actually started to hold back right there because I was afraid I was going to crash into them. So let's see what they're doing here. You guys going to make it cleanly? All right, looks like they're driving a little cleaner now. By the way, I should mention, the way I'm doing this where I know where to brake, since you don't have any driving line or anything like that, and there are very few things to look at for indicating, is on this one, we do it right as we cross the start-finish line, and then on the other one, you'll look to your left, and there's a barrier you'll see. And once we cross by that barrier, oh, yep, I got a penalty. Never mind the fact the dude bounced off the wall to hit me, I got a penalty. That is great. But right there was the barrier. We just passed it, and you would, no, there's the barrier, right there. That's where you would start braking. You see it off to the left, kind of a road entered as well, and oh. I gotta do the penalty. I hope I don't have to do it this lap because it's too late now. That's where the entrance was, and if I could have crossed the grass to try to do the penalty, I'll just get disqualified. Yeah, that's fair, isn't it? I know I have to get to the pits. I know. I'm going super slow because I'm afraid of any sort of penalty. That guy is still bouncing off the wall. Every single corner, he just hits the wall. That's what it is. That's great. So in order to pass him, I don't even know what I have to do for sure there. All right, so we're going to go real slow into this one so I can make sure I get into the really thin penalty road. Make sure I don't touch the dirt. If I touch the dirt here, I'm going to lose entirely. What? Why? What did I do? It said go to the pits. I'm in the pits. Apparently no, it didn't want me to go to the pits. What's that? What is that? Like, if it at least told me what I did wrong, I'd be okay with this, but I have no idea what I did wrong. So if I ever get into that situation again, well, I'm screwed because it's gonna have the exact same outcome. That is ridiculous. Absolutely ridiculous. Either way, I lost my front and rear bumper, so we're going to buy some new ones real quick. So we're just going to go with the custom bumper. I think custom was the one I was using before, right? Let's make sure. Yeah, it was the custom. Custom bumper in the front and rear. And then we got to install them real quickly. Then we'll be good to go again, and the colors don't match again. But you know what? That's the style now. I'm going to paint it when I have more parts that are mismatched. But only two parts, I'm not going to bother with it. And you know, I'm kind of curious now. I'm looking at it. What is audio? Is there anything even here that actually even is clickable? Nope. Nothing in there that's actually clickable. Interior, there are a few things, I think. Not in decorations, not in extras, though. Seats, I'm pretty sure there's some seats. Yep. Pedals, you've seen those before, I think. Gear knobs, nothing. Dashboards, nothing. Steering wheels, there's a few there. And then, what else do we got? We got, nothing, I'll say. Well, actually, there's body kits. Hey, there's actually one for this one that has all the parts all in a box. That's kind of convenient, but I already have the parts, so I don't need that. Neon lights? Oh, we could actually install those. Except it's daytime, you wouldn't be able to tell. We could get a different muffler if we really wanted to. Except it doesn't really... Like, I don't think I'll notice the visual difference enough for it to be worth my money. Lights and windows. That actually might be fun to play around with later. I'm just seeing what they got because I never actually poked through here. You can actually buy a whole chassis now. That's different. And body parts, we've seen those before. You know what? I saw the police siren, but it's not compatible with my car. Everything else is. That's so deceptive. Why would you do that to me? Okay, now that I'm done messing around in there, let's go ahead and fully repair this car, which is going to cost me $5,000, and try this once again. And I got to be extra careful this time. And I crashed the game, so I just lost the entrance fee. Super. Well, I tried to do the race again, and it crashed again. And then, as I was sitting here, I just noticed that this tire only has 7% wear remaining. That means if I tried to do an endurance race with it, it would be a bald tire by the end of the race, which could cause me to crash. So I'm going to just swap on brand new tires for this whole car because I want to make sure that at the end of the race, I still have a car that can hold on to the road. If I have bald tires at the end of the race, I'll spend all my time racing and then crash at the end and just be really, really disappointed. So let's go ahead and put those fresh ones on. So looks like 100%, 100%, 100%, 100%. Perfect. Now we're going to try this race once again, and hopefully it doesn't crash this time. Okay, thank goodness it didn't crash there. And hey, my car's starting to look like their car. I have the front and rear bumpers painted white just like their cars, except, well, the whole rest of my car still has that crazy awesome paint job. I almost tried to launch that like the drag car where you wait and then you hit the accelerator. I forgot. I could just hit the accelerator and let it go. Now, this is going to be the worst corner right here because I have to make sure I don't get hit by the AI. And, ooh, these tires are not... Oh, that's bad. So I think these tires are so fresh, they're a little too grabby. You saw right there, I started to lift up a little bit. Got to make sure I don't do that again, so... Hopefully the tires will wear down and it'll work better over time. Kind of like in a real race where you warm up your tires. I'm just wearing them down until they have less grip because that's the ideal amount of grip for me. All right, right there, it didn't seem like it lifted up as much. Maybe I was just coming in a little too fast because I was scared of being rear-ended by the maniacs behind me. Because if they rear-end me, who gets penalized? Me, of course. I still don't get that logic. You know, it's basically just the game was made where it's like, was there contact between the cars? Oh, it must have been YBR's fault. Penalize him. That's the way it's basically made. It doesn't matter what caused it, it's your fault always. You could be slowing down for a corner in the perfect racing line. They come in way too fast, slam into you. Yeah, it's your fault still. Yep, totally your fault. I really don't like racing on this game in these circuits because of things like that. Like the same thing with cutting the corners. Oh, you just barely touched the apex of the corner? Well, that's a penalty. You did something, that's a penalty. This game loves handing out penalties. And ooh, a 35-second lap. I think that's faster than any of the laps I did before. So these new tires are actually helping me out, even though I felt like I was going a little bit slower. Interesting. So I think things have calmed down a bit, so there probably won't be much happening now. So I'm just going to cruise through some laps until anything interesting happens. Bad news. I'm coming up against some people in front of me, and I'm going to have to try to pass them. This is where things go terribly, 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 terribly wrong. Don't you dare hit me. I swear, that guy looked like he just wanted to hit me. And I'm afraid he's going to rear-end me now. What the? Did that guy just lose his roll cage? How do you lose your roll cage? Why in the world? What? That makes absolutely no sense to me. How in the world do you possibly lose your roll cage? Who installed this roll cage? He is the worst. You need to fire that dude because that roll cage was doing absolutely nothing for you, dude. I have never seen that before. I mean, I swear that's what that looked like, was the roll cage. Let's see if we see it coming up around this corner again. I didn't see it there. I don't know where it was bouncing to. I was just like, I was laughing so hard, I don't even know exactly where it happened. That was weird. Oh goodness. Coming in a little too fast. Got to extra brake this thing. Don't touch that wall. All right. That's why I make sure I brake a little bit early, because right there I braked late and I still made it without crashing. I was too busy thinking about that roll cage though. That thing messed me up. So we got another car. We're going to try to just kick the inside line and get through them. Got to make sure we go pretty fast through here not to get rear-ended. I hear them bouncing off the wall, I think, or something, so I should be pretty safe. All right, clean. Oh, no. I braked really late. Oh, little bit of impact. Ah. Hopefully that doesn't mess up my handling, because if the car starts pulling to the right, I am really in for some trouble here. Or if it even just steers left, worse. What? Get back to the road? What? Because I hit the bumper that fell off of their car, I got a run-out penalty. Yeah, that makes literally no sense whatsoever. I don't get how the game says, oh, you're 2 inches off the ground? Oh, obviously you ran off the track. No, I just bumped a dude's bumper, and now I'm so angry I'm not even hitting my racing line and braking at the right spot. Oh, man, I gotta just calm myself down and just keep racing. It's an endurance race. You get angry, you'll screw yourself over. Trying to watch out for any bumpers. It looks like there's none there. So I guess the pieces of the car that fall off just fade away eventually, because that's the same thing that happened with the roll cage earlier. We're at lap 15 out of 20, though. We're getting there. I don't even know if I should try to pass this guy, because passing people never ends well. Ever. Oh, he doesn't even have brake lights, so I can't even know when he's braking. Thanks. You had to crash into the wall so many times you lost those, huh? Awesome, dude. Yep, right into the wall. There goes piece of his car. And now he's trying to cut me off. So usually I'm the person with the beat up car. Not the case in the endurance races. The AI will beat their car up hard during the race. So I'm just going to try to take the inside line. Nah, I can't quite get there. I don't know if I could take him on the straights either. Like, I think I have a little bit more power, but not a lot more. And then I got to slam hard on the brakes right here, and I'm afraid I might get hit. But they're slowing my lap times down. I got to get around them. That was only a 38-second lap. That's like 2 seconds slower than normal. All right. I got past them. I just don't want to get rear-ended. Perfect. That was a perfectly executed pass. Okay, I got some bad news right now. My front right tire is not doing so well. You look at the bottom right there, you can see that thing is bright red, and I can definitely feel it when I'm going to the corners. This thing is not turning in as hard as it used to. Like, I gotta go a little bit slower through those corners now, because I can't even hit a 35-second lap anymore, and I'm basically only hitting 36s. My concern is how it'll get later on. Like, right there, that was a 37, and I had nobody in front of me, so I have no excuse. So I'm just hoping it'll hold on for a couple more laps here. I gotta go faster than the car behind me, because if they hit me, I'm screwed. I might just let them pass, and okay, they just crashed into another car. That'll work too. I think we're gonna be okay. Okay, I think this car might be doing something where it's going a little bit to the right, just pulling that way, because I don't know how I would have hit that wall otherwise. I felt like I was going in a pretty much a straight line at the start of that. Yeah, this thing is not doing so well. Okay, it is going to the right there. I could tell it's pulling to the right. I got a huge gap. Just make use of the gap. Go nice and slow and steady. I see a guy trying to come onto the racetrack. If he pops into the middle of the track and I crash into him, my fault. Yep, totally my fault. It's always my fault. It's always YBR's fault. It's always his fault. You know, it's funny. One video, and what do? One single race. That's it. One single race. But we also made a crazy paint job, so it's not all bad. And I know I'm leaving the last few laps totally unedited, because I don't know when something might happen here. It's scary. One more lap. Braking a little earlier than normal. I see a bumper. If I hit that, I might get a runoff penalty for going in the air a little bit. Oh my goodness, this steering is awful. It's even worse than before. All right, what is that guy doing? He's just sitting there? All right, we're going to just go by him. Start braking super early. I have everything to lose with the mistakes. Just make sure you don't make any. Oh, man, I was coming to that corner fast, even though I braked early. That tire is just absolutely ruined. I think it's because I bounced off the wall a couple of times. That damaged it. There's the finish line, though. A super slow lap to win the race. Oh, wait. Oh, no, you idiot. Why did you do this? I forgot. It keeps going after you cross the finish line. So I lost a couple of body panels. Hopefully the engine didn't fall out. If the engine fell out, I basically lost a ton of money on that race. Oh, yep, the engine fell out. My beautiful, magical engine is officially gone. And on that depressing note, I'm going to end this video. So until next time, this has been YBR. I'll see ya.